flat and fat. Those were the two words that Sarah thought of when she looked in the mirror, which she did a lot. How could somebody with such a curved belly be as flat as an ironing board everywhere else? Other girls could describe their shapes as being like an hourglass or a pear. Sarah was shaped like a potato. Looking at her bulbous nose, her prominent ears, and how all her parts seemed stuck onto her body at random, she was reminded of the Mrs. Mix-and-Match doll she had as a kid. The one with the different eyes, ears, noses, mouths, and other body parts you could stick onto her to make her look as hilarious as you wanted. And so that was the nickname she came up with for herself, Mrs. Mix-and-Match. But at least Mrs. Mix-and-Match had Mr. Mix-and-Match. Unlike the girls at school, whom she called the Beautifuls, Sarah didn't have a boyfriend, or any prospect of one. Sure, there was one guy she looked at, dreamed of, but she knew he wasn't looking at or dreaming of her. She guessed that she, like Mrs. Mix-and-Match in her single days, would just have to wait around until some equally unfortunate-looking guy came along. But in the meantime, she needed to finish getting ready for school. Still looking at her worst enemy, the mirror, she applied some mascara and pink-tinted lip balm. For her birthday, her mom had finally given her permission to wear a little light makeup. She gave her dull, mousy brown hair a thorough brushing. She sighed. It was as good as it was going to get, and it wasn't good. The walls of Sarah's room were decorated with photos of models and pop stars she had cut out of magazines. Their eyes were smoky, their lips full, their legs long. They were slender, curvy, and confident, young, but womanly. And their perfect bodies were wearing clothes Sarah couldn't even dream of affording. Sometimes, when she was getting ready in the morning, she felt as if these goddesses of beauty were looking at her with disappointment.
Oh,
they seemed to say,
is that what you're wearing?
Or, no hope of a modeling career for you, sweetheart. Still, she liked having the goddesses there. If she couldn't see beauty when she looked at the mirror, at least she could see it when she looked at the walls. In the kitchen, her mom was dressed for work in a long floral print dress. Her salt and pepper hair long and loose down her back. Her mom never wore makeup or did anything special with her hair. And she had a tendency to put on weight around her hips. Still, Sarah had to admit that her mom had a natural prettiness she herself lacked.
Maybe it skips a generation, Sarah thought.
Hey, Cupcake, Mom said. I picked up some bagels. I got that kind you like with all the seeds. You want me to pop one in the toaster for you?
No, I'll just have a yogurt,
Sarah said, though her mouth watered at the thought of a toasty everything bagel slathered in cream cheese.
I don't need all those carbs.
Mom rolled her eyes.
Sarah, those little yogurt cups you live on have only 90 calories in them. It's a wonder you don't pass out from hunger in school.
She took a big bite of the bagel she had fixed for herself. She had put the top and bottom halves together, sandwich style, and cream cheese squished out when she chomped it.
Besides, Mom said, her mouth full, you're much too young to be worried about carbs.
And you're much too old not to be worried about them.
Sarah wanted to say, but she stopped herself. Instead, she said,
a yogurt and a bottle of water will be plenty to hold me over until lunchtime.
Suit yourself, Mom said. But I'm telling you, this bagel is delicious.
Unlike most mornings, Sarah actually made it to the school bus in time, so she didn't have to walk. She sat by herself and watched YouTube makeup tutorials on her phone. Maybe on her next birthday, Mom will let her wear more than mascara and BB cream and tinted lip balm. She could get what she needed to do some real contouring to make her cheekbones more pronounced and her nose less bulbous. Getting her brows done professionally would also really help. Right now, she and her tweezers were fighting a daily battle against a unibrow. Before first period, as she got her science book out of her locker, she saw them. They strutted down the hall like supermodels doing a runway show, and everybody stopped what they were doing to watch them. Lydia, Jillian, Tabitha, and Emma. They were cheerleaders. They were royalty. They were stars. They were who every girl in the school wanted to be, and to every boy in the school wanted to be with. They were the Beautifuls.